Welcome back to Fresh. I'm your boy, Jesse Havea, a.k.a. Brita Filter, also known as the Moana of Manhattan. And welcome to my world. Oh my goodness, come into my room. This is my castle where all the magic happens. Well, Brita's magic happens up in this gig. I have all of my wigs that I wear. There keeps on getting more and more and more and more, and it just gets crazier and crazier. But it's nice to have them up so they get the hell out of the way. And yes, we have our lovely neon for anyone who walks up into this gig who forgets who the head in charge is right there. This is where I've become very successful in this small ass room in Manhattan.
What you looking at?
I grew up Mormon, so we were LDS. We were very like into. We were very musical. We were a very musical family. I saw my first theater show, The Phantom of the Opera, when I was in the sixth grade, and it changed my life forever. I was like, when I grow up, that's what I want to do. I want to perform. So then I went to school for musical theater, college. And then it kind of just transitioned into drag. I was honestly so sick of doing these old white people musicals that I wanted to create my own platform and talk about things that I wanted to talk about instead of playing the Tongan bitch to the left in South Pacific. If I have to do that one more time, it wasn't gonna happen. I went to my first drag show in Phoenix, Arizona, and it was my first experience seeing a drag queen, but I remember feeling like uneasy because I didn't really know this world. These men up in these gowns looking fabulous, giving the most intricate performance I've ever seen, the most amazing lip syncing. I mean, I was doing that in my room as like a fifth grader, just trying to live my fantasy, and this bitch was doing it and trying to win money. I was like, this is amazing. I get so hot. As a Tongan man, I hate being too hot and wearing all this bullshit and having my strapped to my that sucks. I remember my auntie, when she found out that I was doing drag, she was like, before you become too big, you need to go to Tonga and you need to do the Miss Galaxy pageant. And I had no idea what this pageant was. I watched it on YouTube. It is everything. I want to be a judge. If you're watching this, I want to be a judge on that pageant. My dad is from the kingdom of Tonga. He lives in Hawaii now. So my dad is like FOB, fresh off the boat. And my mom is like this cute little white lady from Ohio. I love it. People don't know what I am, especially on the East Coast. People are like, wait, what's Tongan? I mean, now, since we had like the Olympics and we have some other Polynesian people coming out, but I think I'm like the first mainstream Polynesian Tongan drag queen.
You're thirsty?
Having RuPaul really changed a lot of things for me. People are afraid and people make assumptions over things that they're not sure of. Now it's on the mainstream, so like people don't look at it weird as much, but more of as a LGBTQIA plus artistic platform. My dad's side of the family, my Tongan side of the family, is incredibly Mormon. So it took a lot of education and for them to realize that it's for entertainment purposes. That's why I do drag. I don't think they realized until they could pay the bills that they were okay with it. And then they started to see me on TV and they're like, well, if he's on TV, I was like, oh. Of course you like it now because I'm on TV. But when I wasn't on TV, I'll see you now. Making sure that I have a balance and that I have, I take care of Jesse and not only Brita all the time. So make sure I get that good eats too, not just Brita.
My sister got this for me for Christmas one year, and I keep it at the front of the door, and this is specifically a rainbow mantapa. Kind of bridges the gap between me being LGBTQIA+, but also having being a Tongan man and woman at night. So I really love it, and it reminds me of my heritage and my family that I love so much.